Welcome viewers. Hi everybody. Welcome to the new class related to research methodology. In this special topic, we are dealing with the chi-square testing in research. What are the conditions and what are the uses of chi-square testing? It's a parametric test. We'll explain what is a parametric test, and chi-square test is very useful in research methodology whenever we have to accept or reject a null hypothesis. Let us see the details within a short time. The test is based on chi-square distribution. And chi-square tables are available in physical and statistical, mathematical and statistical tables, chi-square table, t-test table, etc. tables, normal distribution tables, etc. are available. Chi-square test is based on the chi-square distribution. Chi is represented by the Greek letter chi. It is squared. That is chi-square. It is used for comparing small variance to a theoretical population variable variance. In a non-parametric test, no assumption about the parameters of the population is made. Here, ours is a parametric test and there are various assumptions related to that. For example, in our parametric test like a chi-square test, or t-test, the population is assumed to be normally distributed, or if there is a normal distribution, it is strictly following a Gaussian curve or normal distribution curve. But such an assumption is not made in a non-parametric test. There is no assumption at all about the normal distribution, etc. The non-parametric tests originally were applied in sociological and psychological research. But it was made by the scientist Robert Parkett, who started applying this test in other areas of research. Now it is very popular because they can be applied to any type of distribution, chi-square test. Easy to compute, and they can be used in situations when parametric test cannot be applied. So that is a wonderful use of the chi-square test. And let us see what are the conditions for applying the chi-square test. We have seen what is the chi-square test. It is specially useful for parametric test. Condition for applying chi-square test can be summarized as 4. That is suitable for random data. It is suitable for independent item sample. And condition is that a total item should be greater than 50. In the sample, many small group can be there, but any small group should have at least 10 items in them. That is a condition for them. Or, I will repeat once again, the condition to be satisfied for applying chi-square test is data should have been collected at random and it is suitable for random data. The second one is the item should constitute of samples. The item constituting the sample should be independent, or in other words, it is suitable for independent item samples. Number three is the total number of items should be at least 50. There should be altogether 50 items. But what happens is there could be any number of small groups, but no group should contain less than 10 items. If all these four conditions are satisfied, we can just apply chi-square test in the area related to the research. Now, let us think about what are the usefulness of this chi-square test. It has been already The chi-square test is used for different purposes. Different purposes can be summed up as two, as follows. The uses of chi-square test is, first one is chi-square test is used as a goodness of fit. That means it is perfect tallying of observed and estimated values whenever there is, we can use it. In regression, the residual error will be minimum whenever there is a matching between them. Hence, the regression equation is a very good fit. What is the meaning of this chi-square test as a goodness of fit? Let us once again think about it. Goodness of fit implies perfect tallying of the observed and estimated value. For instance, in regression equations, if the estimated value match with the actual value, then the residual error should be the minimum. What is the first? Second one, the residual error minimum. The meaning is, if the estimated value match with the actual value, then the residual error would be the minimum. Which means that regression equation is a very good fit for this. Similarly, a chi-square, in chi-square, if the observed data and the estimated data do not have significant difference, that is the calculated value of chi-square and the given degree of freedom, then the estimation is said to be good fit. If there is no significance in the difference, we say that the estimation or estimate is a good fit. The difference between the estimated value and the observed value, even if there, can be explained through the sampling fluctuations or some error due to the sampling, selection of sample. Next, second use of main use of chi-square test is as a test of independence. We can see that chi-square test examines whether two attributes are associated or not. Example, the effectiveness of a particular drug in treatment of medicine can be established by chi-square test. We can study the association of control of that particular disease and effectiveness of that drug through chi-square testing. Then, computed value can be compared with the table value of chi-square test, and we can null hypothesis accepted or rejected on the basis of the comparison of the chi-square value. So that is a very important use of chi-square testing. Let us think once again. Chi-square test is applied to examine whether two attributes are associated or not. For example, in the treatment of a particular disease, that particular medicine or drug, the effectiveness in controlling that disease can be established by using chi-square test. How? The association with the control of the disease and the effectiveness of that medicine or drug can be studied. Usually the estimated value and the observed value are processed with the formula of the chi-square, and the computed value is compared with the table value of the chi-square. If the compared value, computed value is greater than the table value of the chi-square, then null hypothesis is rejected. I will repeat once again, if the computed value is greater than the table value of the chi-square, then the null hypothesis is rejected. And the question is, if the computed value is lesser than the table value of the chi-square, what will you do? Yes, you can accept the null hypothesis. I repeat, if the computed value is lesser than the table value of the chi-square, then the null hypothesis is accepted. With this, let us stop today's class. We'll come with a deeper insight into the research methodology in the coming classes. If you find this type of video useful, please do subscribe. Okay, thank you for listening. Bye.